I will give an overview about some latest news in the automotive safety and security standards and the combination of thereof. That's the agenda. First, the standardization landscape, a nice picture, which is updated each 5-6 months because something new arises, as a new standard activity, some new group and so on, in this one area. Then, of course, a status about the cybersecurity standards 21434, the UNEC cybersecurity regulations, which are basis for a threat catalog, which is later on explained by Christoph in connection with this ThreatGet tool. Then the software update engineering standards, short mention, very important, I think. There are this ISO TR 6409, the report on standardization perspective for automated vehicles, where they identified that about a dozen different groups are doing something in the direction of highly automated vehicles, but not in a coordinated manner and harmonized manner. And one of the recent results in this community is the TR, technical report. That's not really a standard. It has no mandatory requirements. It's just recommendations for 804, which was finished in July this year. So it's really recent. And we have been, Christoph, me, and someone from TT Tech in Vienna, as Austrian partners contributing to parts of this work. And I was on the last meeting face-to-face in Paris in February, was the last allowed meeting in this context. And then we have, of course, the other side, that ITS, Intelligent Transport Systems area. You may remember that I asked one question, because there are different standards already for connected vehicles, yeah, on different levels and even from different ISO groups, which are competing and fighting really at the moment, as I was told from some of our project partners. And then of course, a result was a standardization strategy. We created in a European project, so-called EXO project, which is a large industrial project, and several people here and with and so are active in this project as well, and AVL and others from Graz. And the University of Technology, it has a lot of partners here. And we, of course, from the very beginning. And we have built a strategy for the standardization group. One of the features of EXO projects is that the standardization activities and to try to influence and contribute to standards with results from these projects is a mandatory part of a proposal. Yeah. As in that, and in many cases, I was responsible guy to do that. Okay, this is automotive standardization landscape, which is updated from time to time. This is the latest one from July. It shows the working group 8, safety road vehicles, it's cybersecurity, working group 11, and some related standards and subcommittees which are not so well known, like the extended vehicle line and remote maintenance and remote diagnosis and all these things in SC31, sensor data interfaces, and of course related standards in automated vehicles. You have to look at IoT and artificial intelligence standards, and trustworthiness issues. So there's a lot of things around the basic automotive standards. The basic safety standard is 2602. It's well known here. I need not talk anything, but we are of course collecting at the moment experience from national committees to find a way forward. And next weeks there are some meetings already on this way forward, because each of a standard which is has some importance in industry has a maintenance phase and a validity phase. This is normally 5 years, but already in important standards like 2602 or 6508 from IEC or so, which are basic standards for a certain domain, they start already very early after the publication of the last versions. They start already to think what is needed to comply with future requirements and future technologies. That's always ongoing. So with this nice standard pass, which is a public release specification, it's a not real standard as well. A safety standard which is aimed at the nominal performance issues, which are not covered by 26262. And this was published as well last year, but at the moment it's updated towards a full standard. And that's very important because it had some influence on this automated driving standard 4804 as well. Not too close. And then we have the automotive cybersecurity standards, which are basis for the new UNEC regulations on cybersecurity and software update engineering. That was is finished is was is in a this status for a long time, I must say, because we had about 600 pages of comments to handle. So it's still ongoing, and the main work is done by Christoph Schmidt at the moment, because I have dropped out to other standards in the meantime, and to let, for instance, in digital factory and smart manufacturing, things like that, we have to do this as well. And in, because it becomes a, new, a part of an UNC regulation, it is referenced here that has knowledge of the people building cybersecurity cybersecurity conformant cars, yeah, should be able to be knowledgeable of this 2S434 and some other standards. And because this is so important, and the main requirement of UNEC is that over the whole supply chain, you have to maintain a cybersecurity management system. So that's so easy. Yeah. And therefore, you need an audit guideline as well for that. And that was split out of 21434 because they never would have finished after that. So they said, okay, this audit guideline will become a public available specification in the first run. And this is led by Christoph Schlittner. So he is really leading this group at the moment. And then we have the working group 12, software update engineering over the air. Yeah. This concept started very well, but then it had to be re-evaluated and the work was restructured. And that's what I know at the moment is the status. I'm always following these documents, but it looks as if they have a little a delay now. And we're ongoing. Now I'll come to my favorite example of the subcommittee 31 on extended vehicle. And I do that, I like to do that because it's not so well known in the automotive community, and not even by the projects which were mentioned before, that they had a whole set of vehicle to X, vehicle to grid, web services, the remote repair and maintenance, sensor interfaces for automated driving. There's a lot of subgroups who had already written standards or just are doing something in this area. So that's enormous amount of standards work going on. And even they have extended vehicle time critical applications for road safety. That's a new working group which goes into the real-time area with latencies and communication problems and, of course, security. That's the difference between, for instance, SOCIF and this SC31 group of standards. They consider security from the beginning. And in SOTIF, I proposed that at the early stages and it was rejected. No, no, we will not care about that because it's too difficult now. We start just with the safety side and that's therefore missing at the moment. But a lot of the SOTIF standards are going now into the safety and cybersecurity validation methods which are claimed and proposed by 4804. Then we have, and then of course, as I mentioned before, many subcommittees are doing in an uncoordinated manner things related to automated or highly automated driving, not autonomous maybe, but highly automated, and therefore had created an automatic driving ad hoc group, ADAC, yeah, which has written this report 4609 on standards perspective for automated vehicles, which is very interesting. I will have 2 or 3 slides later on to show. And the standard, it's a technical report as well, it's not a standard, it gives just recommendations because it's not so major, this area, and there's a lot of research ongoing. Therefore, they've just made a technical report, safety and cybersecurity for automated driving systems, design verification and validation methods. The kickoff, the official one on ISO, was in February this year, and it was published in July. Also that's a record-breaking progress from my 40 years in standards. The longest took 12 years. So it's really record-breaking, but it was easier because they had already this white paper, Safety First for Automated Driving, SAFAD, this famous paper, which was written by a huge set of well-known OEMs and first tire suppliers. Also that was really written by very competent people and had contained already most of these principles, particularly the 12 principles of automated driving. These are the cybersecurity standards group 21434, which is now a part of the recommendation for cybersecurity of UNEC, WP29, yeah, and this gives the certification requirement, and this is the ISO pass, which is accompanying that. It's necessary to enable companies and supply chains to establish such a system. Then there's a software update standard, which was proposed by Japan, and I would have expected to be done in subcommittee 31. But because the Japanese guys were in 32, they put it into this. Because software update as over the air would have fit more into this remote update diagnosis and so other standards. But anyway, it's now here, a complement to 21434. Okay. UNECE, which is a, means United Nations Commission for Economic Commission for Europe. And it's for these countries here, which are marked green, mandatory. But of course, they have impact on all over the world, not only just in the member states, this international organization. And the members are type approval authorities. That's opposite to ISO and IEC, where national committees are the members. Here, there are type approval authorities, certification bodies, and a lot of companies, OEMs, and tier one. Then we have this audit guideline here as well. So that these are the two things mentioned here. And that means these standards have more impact than just being a standard. You know that most standards which are written are not mandatory or parts of regulations. Some are, for instance, in the health area, the European directives. And these have a similar status then because they are a requirement in the UNECE regulations for road traffic. Now I come to the subcommittee 31 and automated driving ad hoc group. The subcommittee 31 has a lot of activities, diagnostic protocols over the air, in network, wireless and in-car networks, test on, also in-car and over the air, remote testing, remote maintenance, remote diagnostics, and a sensor data interface group for automated driving function. Here it's really written the word automated driving and was isolated from the rest of the world of automated driving somehow, only by people, but it was not organizationally cooperated really. Then we have the perivehicular data communication. That's all this V2X, V2Grid, V2Infrastructure, yeah? And of course, we have in the vehicle domain all these data collection systems, which are in the end, in automated driving, important for legal enforcement if an accident happens, as far as a proof. Yeah? The data combinations group has a lot of extended vehicle time applications. And you see the goals here, repair, maintenance, inspection, remote inspection, traffic management, vehicle to vehicle, safety as well, safety and security that is marked here particularly, but it's more what they are addressing, transport management. So you see the whole area where you get something out of the vehicle and into the vehicle from outside. So it covers extremely the areas we have discussed before. And it's not the only one in ISO even, because we have the ITS group additionally, which I will mention later. These are this time, what it means, the perivehicular data communications. This is a committee. It is, in, I think in the meantime, it's already in this, yeah. And they say an extended vehicle is an entity still in accordance with the specifications of the vehicle manufacturer that extends beyond the physical boundaries of the road vehicle and consists of a road vehicle, off-board systems, external interfaces, data combination between road vehicles and off-board systems. As you see, exactly what means connectivity is here written down. And the goal is road safety contribution primarily. And then the time critical interfaces means they have to consider timing for emergency braking. You have 100 milliseconds maximum, yeah, for steering. These are functions where the time is the most critical aspect. In other cases, like the transport management, it's not. Yeah? And then you have risk hazard analysis, a particular concept for that. There are a lot of things. They have fixed priority classes. You know, all of the standards have some tables with criticality, with controllability, severity, exposure, and so on. And they have it the same manner. We'll not go into details here, but it's not identical as of the others. That's the important issue here. Yeah. And this REXWE had a standard already in 2017 and 18, yeah, 2077-78, which describes methodology in context of this external vehicle. And this REXWE's methodology gives particular additional design prerequisites and analysis of scenarios. And all these studies are based on classification of situations and scenarios. That's not new. SOTIF does the same and others. But they were before SOTIF already with these approaches. What are the scenarios they are taken? You have heard before, ETSI standards have been taken as an example for the two projects. They did the same. They took the ETSI ITS standards. ETSI is one of the three European from the Commission accepted standardization SDOs, which get even money for particular projects. One of these areas is ITS, the others are small cities. Smart cities and so on. So they get really money, Zen, Zenelec and ETSI for work in these areas. And here you have some scenarios which are taken from there and handled in these committee drafts. Hazardous locations, slow, stationary vehicles, roadworks, work. So all these are listed here and analyzed. We will not go into detail here, but anyway, see a lot of important issues which are also handled partially in this 4804 and other related, and it's taken up somehow. Okay, then what I really liked some time ago was the topic trustworthiness. Yeah, I have later on some more detailed slides. And there was a group in the IoT standardization area of Subcommittee 41 on swarm intelligence. And one of the proposed scenarios we tried to bring in was this automated driving use cases with interacting and communicating vehicles. That's a swarm, an undefined swarm, so to say. And that was to put this report should consider this and start work here on collaborative vehicles. Unfortunately, this nice group was disbanded last year, and I do not even know why until now. I never got hold of the convener and then afterwards, not by the official channels. Also I think the convener gave up or something like that. And this was another very interesting scenario here. Cooperative systems with cooperative automated vehicles, cooperative vehicles, non-cooperative vehicles. That was one of the pictures we have started to discuss and think about the risks and the safety in cybersecurity issues. But unfortunately, okay, what you see that many groups do a lot of interesting work in this area. That was just an example to show what could have been very interesting as well. Now we go to this automated driving ad hoc group report. I mentioned first because it was finished before and it is a basis for the further coordinated way of ISO working on standards and what they try now to organize. Yeah? They had taken up some of the so-called subcommittees, 31, 32 is ISO 26262, and then cybersecurity, 3357 is electric, 37 is electric vehicles, 39 is human interfaces and users, interfaces and all the things. And then they tried even to take into account this opponent TC204 on ITS. Yeah. At least they mentioned some of their work in their report in the tables. And you see what the standards are for. You see all of them do something for higher automated vehicles, but not in a coordinated manner. And I remember that some years ago, I mentioned it already in an ISO meeting. Nobody was interested. But one day, the top committee took it up for somehow and at least try to do something. What does this report say? It's a report, also give some recommendations and have a conclusion, which I mentioned afterwards. Yeah. Also, they have future needs classified of vehicle systems, the reaction of the vehicle, like minimum risk maneuvers should be handled. And they made a list of what are the interesting topics of the vehicle system, together with this TC204 ITS, the human factors, which means driver monitoring, external and internal human machine interface. That means they already thought, how should an automated car signal something to a passenger, bicyclist, but you know, give way is just a movement with your hand of the driver. What should a car do? And people are really thinking about that. So you have to, at least for a long time, be in a system with automated. The most easy thing would be to have only automated vehicles. Yeah? The worst thing is a mixture of all together in a city. These are the scenarios. And they even thought about that and made some, had some, collected some ideas. And of course, safety requirements, that's clear. Safety first is a principle everywhere here that concerns perception, that includes artificial intelligence, of course, and algorithms. Data storage to prove what has happened the last minute before something some accident was. This automated driving DSS data storage is a specific aspect for electric vehicles. They have particular risks with batteries and so. Validation, connectivity, digital mapping. So I was in this Paris meeting and there were people from companies working on these digital precise maps. Yeah? So that is included from the very beginning as a part of the backup information besides roadside and vehicle-to-vehicle communication. And then, of course, the vehicle infrastructure integration. You have seen that, I think, in the examples before as well. So that's a topic everyone is working on. Okay? Okay, and that was the follow-up and way forward, the final resolutions. First, they wanted to, that the TC22 is a top committee of these road vehicles, yeah? Want to create a coordination group, and so this report was just a first exercise, yeah? And wanted them to invite TC204, particularly the intelligent transport systems, and propose already to co-chair these groups, yeah? And so should even get some terms of reference for this work and so on together. It was planned end of last year. There was not so much progress in the meantime, but anyway, it's interesting that at least they tried. ISO has a technical management board on the top level above all TCs, yeah? And they wanted to create them a small efficient consulting group, yeah, which should, based on the knowledge which is already in some of these documents of both ISO 204 and TC22, yeah, and wanted to start a consulting initiative. And that's a topic where we are interested in, of course. Okay, this ISO TDR 4804 white paper is based on 12 principles for automated driving, which had already written down in the white paper, and then later on we will find it now, the 12 principles in standard. That means fail operational or fail safe and fail aware. Yeah? That of sufficient time to transfer to the operator. Operational design domain is a typical, it should be defined in which under which conditions and environment this automated car should work. It need not be everywhere. So maybe on a highway, but not in a city. So according to this SAE levels. The handover issue, yeah, by vehicle, it can happen, and by the operator, and there are minimal risk considerations. You need time in case that handover fails. Something has to go into at least a degraded or stop mode, depending on the situation. The user responsibility changes, yeah, and of course, the vehicle-operated automated driving status has to be the interdependencies have to be considered. So that is a very severe. Then you have safety and security assessment issues, passive safety for crash scenarios, so, and the behavior in traffic, yeah, which should be predictive and measurable for the other road users. So that's a very important issue. It, for instance, an interesting issue, Teslas had a lot, an unusual high number of rear crashes. So from behind, someone is crashing to it because the behavior of this highly automated car is different from a human one because it brakes too fast for a normal traffic flow, and therefore it has an increased number of the sale. You see, even such simple issues have to be considered. That means people need some warning if a car is in automated mode, and all the things are part even of this 4804. So we will find a short chapter about that as well. So that's a very important issue, and normally people don't think so really about that, but that is critical in practice. Data recording. You have the privacy issues here as well, was mentioned before, safety, security, and privacy. You have to look at all the time. And of course, you need a safe layer to be fail aware. An interesting issue is that this terminology. In SOTIF, safe operation is the basic term. And in our projects like AutoDrive, it was the way, there's it now. They define safe operation that it contains a full functionality in case of failure. And therefore, they define this new word, yeah, fail degraded. So you see, and I was in this discussion with the government convener of the SOTIF group protested, I protested. But you see things like that happen. It's not so bad, so critical. But anyway, you see that from this understanding, you can get different rules in the end. That's the issue. Then this standard has 7 fail-safe capabilities defined and additional fail degraded capabilities and 5 challenges. So that is throughout the standard defined for each of these points and the mapping between these points, some recommendations. The 5 challenges are here, statistical demonstration that the avoidance of unreasonable risk and positive risk balance. That's a rule which does already exist by the National Highway Traffic Authority in the United States, by the German ethics guideline for automated driving. There are a lot of guidelines already which say that is a very important. You must only be allowed if you can prove a positive risk balance. Nobody says zero risk. That makes no sense. Although the commission had once a program, zero accident it was called. But anyway, that is important. System safety with the driver interaction, that means the takeover maneuvers particularly. Consideration of scenarios, currently not known, that means how to get into this fail degraded mode. Validation of different system configuration variants, this is another issue which all producers of cars do have. Anyway, it's not typical for this case here. And of course, the subsystems with machine learning. That's a particular issue, and that's a very open issue. I mean, there's trustworthiness group of the AI standards, so that's in general very interesting. Yeah? Here you have this different fail-safe capabilities and the list of failed degraded. We will not go into them, but they are mapped onto the 12 principles. So which principle needs which of these capabilities? Yeah. So you can have a full matrix and explanations. Right? Therefore, it's a rather thick document. I have here the draft report, which is identical with the final report. And if someone is interested, he can look into it. These 12 principles were reclassified and grouped. That was very important, a long discussion in two web conferences. One was the automated vehicle-related aspect, that means cybersecurity, data recording, passive safety and safety assessment. Then the automated driving system cases. Safe operations, a safety layer to find this degraded mode in the correct one, behavior in traffic, that means to fulfill the rules, and the operational design domain, that means the definition in which context this should function automatically. And then, of course, you have human factors, very important, the role of the user, the vehicle operator initially take over, the request of the takeover and this interdependency, which I mentioned before. Okay. Now a short abstract on trust. In systems engineering standards, trust is defined to a degree to which a user or a stakeholder has confidence that the product or system will behave as intended. And it's called the so-called SQUARE, System and Software Quality Requirements and Evaluation, which is a standard in systems engineering. Hey, so get this one. And the trustworthiness is defined by the advisory group 7 of GTC1. GTC1 is the basic group for ISO and IEC handling topics of common interest. And the main topic is information technology. Therefore, all these standards, which cover topics like IoT and artificial intelligence and security and so on, are in this GTC1 in some groups. The advisory group was created to define this new word, trustworthiness, this new term, which goes beyond safety, security, and the classical dependability, because it covers all stakeholder interests. It might even be financial ones. Yeah? Also, and you have to set for each system development, it's a system term, yeah, the requirements and the stakeholder expectations, and they may be quite different. It's not only safety and security, it might be much more performance issues, and of course, maintainability, user services, and so on and so on. And these are a lot, this list is a nice, what could be included. And I remember a project proposal, Trusted, where we discussed long about that, and we in the end defined for each use case, which was in the project Trusted, yeah, a trustworthiness profile. That means each user say which of the characteristics are important for us, and we have to make a proof of concept. Yeah, so that is the approach normally you have. And that in therefore your safety first is no longer sufficient, and the automated driving applies therefore under these considerations fail operational and all the related terms I mentioned before. Yeah? And trustworthiness can be applied to services, products, technology, data, information, it's more, and even to governance of organizations. Yeah? It depends on in which context it is. Yeah? And of course, you need a framework. There are standards even on governance frameworks now and system engineering practices. So that is important to get trust of users in highly automated products. That's the reason why people think about that, yeah? And to build confidence in the public. Yeah? We made an assessment in AutoDrive, what people think about automated driving. And the younger people are quite nice. Older ones more restrictive, and some even said, I never would sit in such a car. Okay, now we have this Secretas project and AutoDrive project. I must make a little bit dissemination as well here. And there's what important is shown in the top picture, yeah. we have multi-concern relation because all these trusted issues are more than safety and security. You have to have multi-concern certification. I wanted to ask a question on certification before, but there was no chance. And we have to look at this. We have even a workbook, a task on that, how to look on certification. And then, of course, safety, security, privacy, and you need co-engineering, so you cannot separate. And it's really a problem. And for many decades, these communities don't even talk to each other. Yeah. And at the moment, it's so in some areas, privacy is neglected and becomes important now. Automotive is an example, and in industry, and safety and security. We had to fight to get at least a technical report out of IEC on a framework for functional safety and security on this co-engineering. It was not easy to get because each community wanted to say, no, we don't want to touch that. Yeah. Also, 12 years ago, I made at a conference, NATO Advanced Studies in Poland, I made a statement that we need a joint life cycle and a joint co-engineering, and nobody was interested. And nowadays, there are a lot of approaches already, even standards, not only in projects, European research projects, where it is co-engineering, AQUAS, AMAS, may you remember, I think WIF was in them as well, yeah, was really a topic to handle. These are the other standards I've mentioned already. So, and now the ITS issue. What is cooperative? Yeah, ITS, that's the last point here. Yeah, and we have ISO TC 204 intelligent transport, we have CEN TC 278 with urban ITS and cooperative ITS and different subgroups. Fortunately, some of them work together. So CEN is not so active as ISO here. And then we have ETSI, ITS. ETSI was mentioned here before as well, in the first presentation, I think. This intelligent transport system at least build on IEEE communication standards somehow, do not develop quite different ones. And these are the most important transition groups here, architecture, communications, nomadic devices in ITS, cooperative systems and integration, mobility. This integration is an important part, which means traffic science and so on. Okay, and there are services which require security. We're not going to details here. Yeah, and now to the strategy. In Segreda's particularly, because Autodrive had already almost finished, but Segreda's is still 1 year ongoing and we had a long discussion with these people who are more on the ITS side in Segreda's. Segreda's means secure safety and security for automotive systems. Yeah. And they look at safety, security, and privacy issues. And they look from different viewpoints, some from the ITS, ISO TC22, road vehicles, some from, and one work which only from ITS. And we said we have to bridge this gap here between these two extended vehicles and ISO 262, because they might divert after some time, yeah, and that's not good. And then, of course, we need a more holistic view on automated driving. You see a list of standards which are relevant here, and it's not the only one. So even the list in this automatic vehicle report, roadmap report, shows 8 pages of standards which are somehow related. And that is, of course, our next task, to try to identify these things, well, what we could do and how, which community additional to join. But of course, we know there is. We have just 1 year, so it needs a long term. So I told before that there were some standards where we worked 8-10 years on them until it was finished. Others are faster. Yeah, but anyway, this risk is there. But at least the group here of ITS and our groups, we know from road vehicles, are long term active, have long term activities here, and that I think might be an interesting outlook to, let's say, find some common solutions.